is Gunter from Dayton Street, fourth grade, and the topic of our project was the organization of the sounds. We began talking about how sounds are organized using notes on a staff, and then we decided to create our own rhythms using the probability wheel, and each student had a chance to spin the wheel and create their own rhythm. And they practice clapping them out and stomping them out, showing what they learned about music and note value and notes. And then we decided to do build sound towers, where we went to see if the size of the tower had anything to do with the pitch and the volume. So we hit each tower with the mallet, and then once we got the measurements, we used an audio recording system called Pro Tools to measure the sounds and the volume and pitch.
About the octave scale. Over here it says, in 600 BCE, famed mathematician Pythagoras dissected music as a science and development, the keystone of modern music, the octave scale. The importance of this event is obvious. Music was a passion of the Greeks. With their supplies, surplus of leisure time, thanks to slave labor.
My name is Jonathan Roman. I'm from Willard H. Brown Academy. I'm gonna talk about our CD. Our CD is about our panpipes and what we did about them. We turned panpipes into music. We made notes into music, and we did a lot of stuff. Then our music teacher, Mr. Pittman, did a show about a guitar on the computer.
I'm pleased to be able to be here today for the annual math fair. And while the format has changed a bit because of state testing, we have our exemplary projects on display here for the students to see. The theme this year was the acoustics of the mathematics in terms of acoustics and architecture. And we see a lot of music. It was amazing to have students say to me they never realized that music was so closely tied to mathematics. And so I asked a few questions about decibel levels and about the use of patterns in mathematics, in music rather, and its application to mathematics. So this is just amazing. This particular group has matched it to the sonic boom, to the sounds that can actually break our eardrums. So this is really fascinating. I think this school is, I've forgotten which, Ridge Street School. And how apropos, because they know they'll be moving into a new building, and perhaps some of the things that they had to do to build that building use some sonic booms to get through the dirt and the ground. We're really pleased to see the quality of the projects, as every year they get better and better. Thank you.
It's even a mystery. Stop me. city. Or will I keep on smoking trees? But I'll just let it go and be, be, be me. I'll be long, babe. Well, well, well. I'll be long, babe. Just be me. I'll be long, babe. Well, well, well. I'll be long, babe. Just be me. Sometimes I don't know what to say. So many
My name is Mariana Martinez. I'm from American History High School, and our project is the Mathematic of the Panpipe. And what we did was calculated the length of each tube, and they came out with a different sound, each one. And also the sine waves. We connected it to a calculator, and we each blew in one of them, and it made the length and the sound of the different panpipes. So that was our project. Thank you. This is from American History High School.
All right, hi, my name is Kashif. I'm from American History High. I'm a junior. My school's project, we were using an equation, this equation that's right here, to calculate the frets on a guitar, to see the distance and everything, and to find out how musicians themselves make guitars and the fretboards and whatnot. This is our guitar right here. It's not exactly like the real thing, but we have four strings. Each of them are different types of strings. This one holds 60 pounds. This one is 40, 30, and then 20. And then we just put them on these eye screws right here and then tightened them up to get the certain tuning that we wanted.